Well, Middle East-focused Norwegian oiler DNO is proposing to put long-suffering investors in Gulf Keystone Petroleum out of their misery with a $300 million US dollar cash and shares bid for the UK group. Now, the putative transaction follows very quickly on the heels of a debt for equity swap that effectively rescued Gulf Keystone but diluted existing holders out of sight. Well, to talk about the potential deal, we're now joined by Colin Smith, oil and gas analyst from Panmure Gordon, who joins us now. So, Colin, what do you make of this proposal?
I think it looks like a pretty smart proposal on the part of DNO. I mean, the proposed acquisition price looks like it would add barrels at about $1 a barrel, and obviously it strengthens DNO's already strong position in the KRI. I think the timing is interesting because effectively Gulf Keystone has had to agree terms with its debt providers that wipe out the existing equity base, who will be left with just 5% of the company once that restructuring goes through. So really, this is a DNO pitch, I think, more to the debt providers than to the equity holders, the current equity holders in Gulf Keystone. So I think it looks quite a smartly pitched deal at this level. I thought it was also interesting that they don't appear to have talked to the board of Gulf Keystone in advance of making this pitch, and it will be interesting to find out in due course if they've had any sort of discussions with the debt providers to see whether they will favour the offer that they've now tabled.
So when you look at the value of this deal, do you think that Gulf Keystone has been a victim of the downturn in the sector, or is this a company that shot itself in the foot?
Well, in a sense, it's a bit like the Tullow story in that it ended up with far too much debt ahead of the development process and was not in a position to sustain the drop in oil prices. And obviously, there have been well-publicized problems of the KRI actually being able to pay the sums owed under the PSAs. And that's really taken the position they are now in, which was that they were forced to do a deal with their debt providers.
So do you think somewhat steadier crude prices now makes M&A more likely in the sector?
I think we can expect M&A to pick up at some point, although it's still at relatively low levels. And the reason for that is that there still remains something of a gap between the price decks that willing sellers and willing buyers can actually trade on. As we start to come more convincingly off the bottom for oil prices, I think we will see much larger levels of M&A pick up.
Very good. Colin Smith, oil and gas analyst at Panmure Gordon, thank you very much indeed for joining us today.
A pleasure.